Hi there. Good afternoon. Good morning. Good evening, whatever time it is that you're joining us. We pray that it's a good time for you. This is a short version. I had a very important appointment, and I want to thank you all for your prayers because it went really well. I'm Helen Mary, and this is Pieta Prayers and Petitions. Today is the last day of our novena that we have been doing to Saint Isidore. And so I'm going to come on for that. Hi, Susan. Hi, Melanie. Oh, it's so nice to see you. I didn't know if anybody would be joining me, but I knew I would be. We're doing the last day of the novena. And usually if I skip a day, I will do our saint of the day because we do want to give honor to all our saints of the day. It's good to see you. Okay. Melanie, did you see Betty won that the beautiful rosary that was in the drawing? Hey, Sooner. Oh, nice. It's so good to see all of you. I was expecting to be by myself and just record, but I sent it out. I did get home earlier, but I had lunch, and then I just rested a little bit, and I said, I'm going to rest for 30 minutes, and then I'm going to go down. But we saw the specialist, took him over there for blood work, lab work, and then we waited to see the doctor. And they're saying that he is very, very stable and he's looking good. All his numbers look good. So we thank Jesus for that. We thank the Holy Trinity for watching over our Luciano. And I especially want to thank all you prayer warriors that keep me on prayer all the time. Thank you so much. Let's keep Ruben in prayer too. He still has that stone and doesn't seem to be going away. And then, of course, we'll keep each other in prayer. And we'll, of course, remember. Yeah, that is great news. He looks good. And this person that we saw, this liver specialist, she's one of the persons outside of myself that said to Luciano, you need to put a ring on that about his now fiance. And he says, oh, by the way, Lisa, I have to tell you, he goes, I put a ring on it. She was so excited. Anyway, so you know what? I got to turn something off because if I don't turn this off, we'll have problems. That OneDrive. So thank you, Saint Isidore. I have had a good week praying this with Saint Isidore because you all know I can have my issues too, but I've had really good internet coverage. I have a good sound. And I'm thanking St. Isidore. I was having some serious printing issues, and that seems to be taking care of itself. So thank you, St. Isidore. He is the patron saint of Pieta prayers and petitions. Oh, is she? Wow, that's a big change from Austin to Dallas. Yeah, let's lift her up. And I met a young woman who is recovering from a liver transplant. Her name is Raquel, and I would like to lift her up. She is doing really good, but, you know, still recovering. All right, so we're going to pray for Sarah and her move. We want her to be safe and to find and just to be happy where she's moving. Good for her. She's an independent young woman. All right, she's driving. Yes, Lord, guardian angels, watch our Sarah. Help her to be safe, get to Dallas safely. All right, we'll have to talk about that later. Have you heard from Santina? Is she doing okay with her going across the pond, as the English say? Let me see. What else? I feel like there was some. Oh, you know what? I do. We're praying for Susan. You're the one that. Okay, Judy has a doctor's appointment, so she's not going to be with us. So let's pray that everything goes well with Judy. It's her knee she's been having trouble with. And sooner, too, they're going to pray that her knees. And M is at therapy. So we're going to just send a quick prayer for Emily that everything goes well with her therapy. Therapy, don't knock that. But I know... Janine, that's who. Oh, I sent a prayer up for. Did you hear anything for Janine? I did pray for Janine. I stopped right then when I got it, Janine Bernard, and I prayed for her. I lifted her. But I felt like there might have been a different. Okay. Does anybody else have any other prayers that we need to mention and lift up today? Okay. Well, let's look at our saint of the day so we can move on. By now, I'm sure you've done all your prayers. I didn't get to finish mine, but I'm going to do them as soon as we hang up. Oh, you know who's not here? Gone in, but let's see if maybe she'll her and Geronimo run errands. It's nice not to be running errands. Okay, so our saint of the day is, her name is Athanasia. Isn't that a pretty name? Kind of like Anastasia, but it's Athanasia. She was a Greek widow and an abbess who lived on the Aegean Islands. Saint Athanasia was the daughter of Christian nobles, Nikitas and Irene. And she experienced the mystical union of a star merging with her heart while weaving at the loom when she was a young girl. She wanted a spiritual life, but as an imperial edict requiring all single women of marriageable age to marry soldiers. So imagine, it's like when you're drafted. She was drafted to be the wife of a soldier. At 16 years old, and at her parents' urgings, she complied with the law and married a young officer. 16 days after her wedding, her husband was killed in a battle with raiding Arabs. She again married, but this time to a deeply religious man who wished to become a monk and left to do so with her blessing. Athanasia agreed and converted her own home into a convent where she became an abbess, which is the head of that order, that place. Moving the convent to Timia, Athanasia became the advisor to the Byzantine Empress during her 7-year stay in Constantinople. And she died when she was in Timia as well. But she served as an abbess, and she was known for her miraculous healing of the sick and those seen as possessed. Saint Athanasia then gave away the bulk of her possessions, converted her home. We said that. And then she began, after she converted her home into a convent, then she began building churches. She served as an abbess and was known for so many miraculous things. She healed the sick and those who were possessed. She moved near the church of Stephen, the proto-martyr. And here crowds flocked to see her as her fame grew. Then she went back to Constantinople seeking solitude as an anchoress in a cell for 7 years. And while she was walled away, she was an advisor to Empress Theodora II. After 7 years, and she returned to Aegina, where she died of natural causes 3 days later on August 14th, 860. Her relics, her bones, preserved at Timia in a specially made burial, and they are revered for their reputed healing power. So even her relics, were performing miracles, her healing powers. So we honor you, Saint Athanasia, and we ask you to pray for us, to pray for all of us who need miracles. Think of someone you know who might need a miracle. And let's go to our blue book and see what our blue book says about Saint Athanasia. Isn't that a pretty name? Saint Athanasia. We learn from Saint Athanasia that whether married or single, we can discern and accomplish God's will for ourselves and others. So true. Father, we offer ourselves in whatever our current situation is to you. Please make us instruments of your will. Amen. Okay. So I'm going to put away our saint of the day. We've been having just the most wonderful, beautiful saints, haven't we? I'm loving them. All right, so I hope by now everyone has said their prayers, because usually after our Saint Michael prayer is when we do our novena. But I'm going to go ahead and do our novena now. And this is day 9. Day 9. Can you believe it's the 9th, our end of our novena? That went by. So for the Saint Isidore novena, we always begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty and eternal God, who has created us in thine image and bade us to speak after all that is good, true, and beautiful, especially in the divine person of thy only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Grant, we beseech thee, that through the intercession of Saint Isidore, Bishop and Doctor, during our journeys through the internet, we will direct our hands and eyes only to that which is pleasing to thee, and treat with charity and patience all those souls whom we encounter. Father, we ask you this through Christ our Lord. Amen. If you have a request, your last request. Saint Isidore of Seville, pray for us. Now we're going to say the Our Father, Hail Mary, and Glory Be. And then we end with a prayer to Saint Isidore. So let's say our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Almighty and eternal God, who has created us in thine image and bade us to seek after all that is good, true, and beautiful, especially in the divine person of thy only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Grant, we beseech thee, that through the intercession of Saint Isidore, Bishop and Doctor, during our journeys through the internet, that we will direct our hands and eyes only to that which is pleasing to thee, and treat with charity and patience all those souls whom we encounter. Father, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And you know, you think about that. Think about that. Because when we go on the internet and you go on YouTube, when I open my channel to YouTube, I often see Karen's gone wild. Karen's get what they deserve. Don't look at those. I stopped looking at them. Don't look at those things that are going to rile you up. Don't look at those things that can maybe form a little stone in your heart that you know, prevents you from fully allowing the Holy Spirit and Jesus to get inside of your soul. So, you know, try not to. Now I watch mostly these animal rescues, which I don't get mad at the people who abandon mistreat. I just cry for the poor dogs because I'm a dog person. I love all animals, but I just hate to see the cruelty to any animal. So let's just take a moment and let's lift up these people who we mentioned. Betty, who says she's getting better. Let's lift up Ruben and Luciano and Raquel, who is still recovering from a liver transplant. Let's lift up Sarah. She makes this new move. We ask the Lord to watch over her, see her safely to her destination, make her home safe. We ask the Blessed Mother also to watch over these people. We pray for Judy. She goes to physical therapy, that she get better every day. We pray for Emily as well. We pray for, and we're also keeping Janine. I think that's how you say her name, Janine, that everything goes in her favor as she goes to court. We pray for justice and fairness. We pray for good health, mental health. We pray for all of those petitions. We lift them up, that are in our Pieta prayer box. We pray for all of those who have mental health issues, and we lift up our St. Difna prayer bowl. We pray for all of those who are in here. We pray for each and every prayer warrior that is here with us today and those who are not with us. We pray that everything is well. We know this is not the usual time, but we pray for you, and we pray for anyone who will drop in. Let's get some likes on there. We pray all these things in your name. Amen, Jesus. Amen, amen. All right, I felt like I'll be here tomorrow at 8:30. Everything goes well. We're still waiting on Ruben, so please pray for him, but thank you so much for these prayers for Luciano. He's just doing, I don't want to say well, he's doing so stable. That's how we say this about his illness. All right, that was it for everyone. Is there anyone else have anything to say before I cut you off and complete my own prayers? Because I didn't do this. So I'm going to sit here and pray my prayers. And then I have some other business that my computers do. Everybody's good then. We'll see you tomorrow morning. And there will be no Novena for a couple of days. I have a couple of topics we're going to cover and revisit. All right. Love to everybody. God bless you all. We'll see you in the morning. Bye. Yes, have a blessed day. You too, Susan.